Welcome back, this is Yama Jack, and today we got Gunslinger Suicidal Hellmark Station. I'm not, but I have been high again, and it was a completely different experience. So I want to talk about it again. When I got high the first time, it was kind of okay-ish, but then largely...
Turns out it's true. Blood is thicker than water.
Hold up. The microphone at a better place here for me and then for you as well, hopefully.
Suits and boots, guys.
So this is always Halloween sets, I guess. Cool. Anyway, so the first time I was high, it was okay, but not something that I would necessarily seek out. You know, it was like a 4 out of 10. Last time I got high, I would say, I'd say maybe like a 6 out of 10. And I think that the difference there is that I didn't have to record. I think that the recording really brought down my mood when I was high that first time. So my stance on it has definitely changed. I'm definitely more pro THC than I was before. But I don't think it's at the point yet where I'd recommend it to anybody necessarily. It's still a hard, you know, hard for me to say, yes, you should try this. But much easier for me to say, hey, I'm gonna, you know, eat a bit of a chocolate tonight. Now, I don't like the chocolates that I bought. They're gross. The THC chocolates that I have there, they're not very tasty. They're not particularly nice. They get stuck in your teeth, and then you get to kind of like just feel this weird, gross chocolate kind of. It's not good chocolate. I thought maybe they'd make, like, you know, good chocolate with weed in it. No, it's bad chocolate with weed. Which is kind of why I'm anti-edibles. For the most part. If I'm going to try it for the first time, I wanted to get an edible just because it's the easiest way to do it. And it's cheap, right? You can buy, like, a single, you know... thing. Whereas if you're getting oils, then you have to buy, like, the whole bottle, you know? But, like, the edibles don't taste good. Right? The oils don't taste good either, but, like, they're cheaper, at least. So, yeah. Yeah, it doesn't taste very good, so. But it was a much better experience when I wasn't having to let down any of my responsibilities. It was a very different experience, one that was significantly better in my opinion. So I'm planning on I've got it open. I just have to wait until I'm done recording, and then I'm gonna pop another chocolate here and have a nice night just being high and just kind of enjoying myself and just, yeah, just relaxing and having a good time. But I don't think that I'd ever do it if I have responsibilities. Even if there's something that I could handle when I'm high, like for instance recording, or something like that. Absolutely not. Once you have the responsibilities and you feel bad about not being able to do them to as well as you would expect yourself to do it while you're, you know, fully sober. It's a bad time all around, I think. Once you get a bad feeling when you're high, it doesn't go away. And I think I can say that as an expert on it now because I've been high twice in my life, you know, recreationally. So I'm an expert. But that's kind of what it seems like, you know? Once you feel bad when you're high, the whole thing is just kind of messed up from that point onwards. You don't get to recover from that. It's a bad trip. Not really a bad trip, but not a particularly nice trip, you know? So, that's my theory on it. You're kind of volatile, I guess? Yeah, volatile's kind of the right word. You're kind of volatile when you're high. You're more vulnerable to mood swings and stuff like that, at least in my experience, again, as an expert on it, having been high twice in my life. a little bit more susceptible to those mood swings. Well, not necessarily mood swings, but I guess you know, in my experience anyway, again, two times, can't really say that I'm much of an expert on it. I will say it, but the reality here is that it could have just been like, you know, I didn't eat enough the first time, or I ate too much the first time, and I, you know, whatever. Like there's a number of things that could be accounting for the experience having been better or worse on both times, you know? A number of reasons. However, from this point onwards, I'm gonna make sure that whenever I'm you know, having some THC, enjoying life a little bit, you know, more. Just more. whenever I'm engaging in some THC shenanigans, I'm just gonna make sure that I have a clear schedule to really be able to sit back and just enjoy it. Cause I got high, I got, you know, as I do, and I just sat down with some friends and just chatted for a while, and I was definitely worse at it than I normally am. But at the same time, I got to. I don't know, it was just enjoyable for me. And I think that I'm still I think I talk more. At least in text. Maybe even in person, I don't know. But at least in text, I think I talk more when I'm high. So I think I might be a little bit more annoying, but my friends have accepted my annoyingness, so it's okay. I don't want to make it a habit, though, you know. I don't want to be getting, you know, stoned every night or whatever. I'm not a stoner, you know. But I'll shoot you through here. That's a cloaker. Okay. Yeah. That's it. I had a good time. Talked to some friends. Had fun. Enjoyed life. Didn't have to worry. No stress. There was no stressor in it, you know. And when I got high the first time, I had a stressor because I had to record and stuff, and that really ended up just picking up crovels everywhere, dude. That really messed up the whole sitch, you know. Really messed up the whole thing. So yeah. Anyway, I've got my fiction up on royalroad.com. Y'all haven't read it yet, I would love if you went and read it. I think y'all have, because I've gotten a fair number of views on it now, and follow, which is pretty sick. It's weird, because I get subscribers on YouTube all the time. We just got a subscriber today. I forget your name. I'm sorry. But we got a subscriber today. I get subscribers frequently, right? It's a frequent occurrence. I have, you know, 70 or something, 80, somewhere around there, right? Like I have a decent number of subscribers, right? Not a lot of them, but definitely a decent number. And then I have like several tens of thousands of views total. I get like another 1,000 views a month, right? Like I get a lot of views, subscribers, all that kind of stuff, right? At least relative to my one follow on Royal Road. But for some reason, this cat's back in the game. For some reason, that one follow on Royal Road just makes me happier than like more than one follow on YouTube or Twitch or something. And I think the reason for it is kind of simple. You know, you can overthink it, and you can think that, you know, hey, I like writing more than I like YouTube, or I like writing more than I like this thing, or I'm just doing YouTube for money, or whatever. You can overthink it all you want, but I think that the reason why that one follow means so much to me is because it's just the first follow that I got on my fiction, having written something. It's like starting anew and getting to rediscover those initial kind of like exciting growth periods, which I'm going to be able to do again once we start the new channel for seriousness, which is coming soon. Yeah, and then also I think the other part of it is that what's this message here? Oculus telling me something. So annoying, so annoying. The other factor is that with YouTube, right? People are finding me because of KF2, right? They're finding me because they like KF2. People are watching my channel because, you know, I have the Prestige Skins video or whatever, which isn't getting that much right now because it's age-restricted. But, you know, we're getting people coming for KF2. Not for me, not for the content I make, but for KF2. And you know, you often stick around because you like me and you like the content that I make and yada, 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 right? Which is fine. I'm very, very happy. I love it. But the difference with the Royal Road thing is that it kind of isn't like that. You know what I mean? Like, on Royal Road with the fiction that I wrote. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I don't think we're going to get him. I don't think I should have taken that shortcut. I don't think it was a shortcut at all. Anyhoozle, so on Railroad, it's the fiction that I made. It's all me, you know. There is no other influence of the game or whatever that the book is playing. It's just entirely me writing what I wanted to write, and then people being like, yeah, I like this, you know. Nobody's sticking around just because it's on Royal Road, right? Like, people are only there because they liked my writing, which is super, super cool. So it was really, really cool to see that one follow. I don't know if it's you, then, you know, you made my day. Congratulations. If it isn't you, then why aren't you following? yeah, it was really cool to see. So it's up there now. It's in the description. Go check it out if you want to. I'm going to be putting up Chapter 2 tonight or tomorrow, probably. Not sure. Probably not tonight, because I'm planning on eating the chocolate, if you know what I mean. Which is going to get in the way of my writing. I'm not a very good creative writer when I'm... high. I'm not the best creative writer when I'm sober, so... The high is definitely not helping towards that end. So the way to finish off the patriarch is to get him just a little bit farther below than where he was right now, and then he starts to run, but he's still like attacking us, so he would have chased us down and stuff or something like that. I don't know. It didn't work. My strategy didn't work. Comedic timing, I suppose. It's okay. It's okay. I'm having fun writing, though. I'm having a lot of fun writing. It's just writing is a lot of fun in general, you know? It's just a lot of fun. Just a whole heck of a lot of fun. There's something about just having an idea and then writing it and then other people reading it. There's just something about that feels really, really good to me. And to a lot of people, that's why people write, you know? Chloe Bessay, who are you? Who are you? Why are you here? Who have you? Why have you come? Etc., etc. It's Friday today. It's a big day. It's the day that, majority of the world doesn't have to work tomorrow. For me, it doesn't really matter. Days of the week don't really affect me all that much. Besides that my parents are home on Saturday and Sunday, so I hate Saturday and Sunday. But besides that, it doesn't really affect me much. Although I guess that is kind of a big effect. I do loathe the weekends because of that. Just sucks, you know. It sucks having to put up with other people in your house. You know, you're 25 years old, supposed to be moved out earlier this year, but then COVID happened and threw a wrench into it. Now you can't move out, and you're committed to making the YouTube stuff try and work at least, and that's gonna delay you. then every weekend you have to wake up and exist with the people who you just really don't want to be around all that often. It kind of sucks. To be quite honest with you. I got a dentist appointment, I believe, tomorrow. I thought it was on the 23rd, but my mother texted me today and said it's on the 21st, so I guess it's tomorrow. I was under the impression that it was the 23rd, so I'm going to have to double-check that, but got a dentist tomorrow. It's nice. I'm looking forward to it. Really, really looking forward to it, actually. For a number of reasons. So the first reason is that last year, I was supposed to go to a dentist appointment in August, but I was sick, so I couldn't. And then we had it rescheduled to like March or something like that. And well, you know, I'm sure you know what happened then. So that one got canceled. Now I've got it coming up tomorrow or the 23rd. I can't remember, but I'm gonna have to double check. It should be tomorrow. I'm guessing that we got the phone call for. I should change it to my number, but whatever. I'm guessing we got the phone call and the message or whatever. So. Probably tomorrow, but yeah. And then earlier this year with COVID especially, I definitely had a lapse in my oral hygiene for a while, so I'm good now. I'm brushing and flossing and all that, but I definitely had like a pretty bad depression that definitely affected my kind of overall hygiene, even oral hygiene being the one that I kind of can't fix by myself. You know, I can have a shower, I can clean up my room, I can, you know, do anything like that, right? I can't, you know, fill in a cavity. I can't, you know, get rid of all that excess plaque or whatever, you know, like, I mean, I could, but it's not, I don't have the stuff necessary when it's, you know, particularly bad. Just go to the dentist, they give you a clean and you get all nice and beautiful and stuff. And then you keep care of your teeth, you know? Now that I'm not depressed, I'll be able to properly do that, which is good. So I'm expecting to get, like, a cavity or two, maybe. I'd fully expect it. Because I definitely wasn't taking care of myself. I wasn't taking care of myself on any front, really. I'm still suffering the consequences of that. My hair, especially. And then obviously the oral hygiene as well is a lasting effect, but it's nice to have the dentist tomorrow go for cleaning. You know, they can kind of put everything back to a baseline of acceptableness, you know, and then I just have to keep it up, and then we're good to go, right? That's what's really, really nice. I'm just really hoping that if I have a cavity, which I expect I do, I might not, but I didn't have the best hygiene, so I'd expect to have a cavity. I'm hoping that, because we're getting a lot of cases of COVID at the moment, I'm really hoping that if I have to get a cavity filled or whatever, that COVID doesn't end up getting to the point where we have to cancel that, because that would suck, you know? Yeah. Anyway, it just sucks having to live at home still. Really, really sucks. Nothing I can really do about it, though, right? Like, I could go get a job, but, like, just to be honest with you, when I have a place to live, it just seems like a bad idea. You know, give up the... I'd be able to avoid the inconvenience of having to live with my parents at the expense of, you know, possibly my health, my family's health, you know, my grandparents especially's health. You know, put myself at risk and my family at risk just so that I can move out of the house like a year or two earlier. Like, it just, it doesn't feel like the right thing to me. It feels a little bit selfish when I'm otherwise able to sustain myself on disability. And I have a very real possible alternative of making money through YouTube or online through other means as well, rather than having to go out and put myself and my family at risk. Also that I can have a little bit more of a comfortable, you know, Saturday and Sunday. It's like, eh. It feels like irresponsible to me. You know, maybe once COVID, I intended initially when I started the YouTube thing for it to be and until like the end of this year kind of thing. I mean, even less than that. But at this point in time, COVID doesn't seem to be going anywhere, so I'm like, I don't know. There's just no reason for me to go out there and start putting myself at higher risk. Because we have like 50 or 60 cases on the island here now. I live on Vancouver Island, West Coast, Canada. Like 50 or 60 cases on the island, and we have a population of like population of Vancouver Island. Can't type, apparently. About 870,000, and like 90% of that live at the southern like tip of the island. Where I live, because I'm part of the 90%. Yeah, we all live down, like, pretty close, for the most part. So. We're not like, packed in here like rabbits, but we're definitely 60 in a population of a million. With like 60 active cases on the island, with a population of just under a million, with the space that we have, I'm like, I don't know. Going out to work at, you know, McDonald's or something. You know, you can wear a mask all you want, and you can social distance all you want. But here's the thing, right? The people who are doing that typically aren't the ones who are getting sick. And then spreading it anyway. So, like, largely, if somebody is sick, and this is kind of going against what I'm saying too, but largely if somebody is sick, they're the kind of person who's going to ignore your personal space and ignore wearing masks. Which is illegal if you're sick to not wear a mask, I believe, but, like, that's they don't care. That's why they got sick. And it just takes, you know, a brief few days of explosive growth to go from like 60 cases to now we have hundreds or thousands to and then, you know, I can't visit my grandparents anymore. I can't you know, if I moved out, then I wouldn't be able to really go visit my family comfortably at all. It's just I would love to have the opportunity to move out, but going out and having to work at a job with people around me and stuff, putting myself at that risk. It doesn't seem like the right answer to make that happen to me. It just doesn't seem like the right answer, you know? Because I can live here. As bad as it is, and it's pretty dang bad. It's not bad from like, you know, oh, you have a roof over your head. Well, I have a leaf over my head. You know, it's not, like, terrible, but everybody's perspective is their own, you know? And from my perspective, my living conditions are suboptimal, you know? I have my own problems. Everybody else has their own problems. It doesn't make anybody's, you know, worse or better or harder or anything. You know, there's no objectivity here. But I can't say that it's that bad in the grand scheme of things. It's not so bad that I'd be killing myself alternatively, right? Like, I'm not at that point. If I was, I'd be getting a job, moving out, and going, you know? But I'm not quite at that point. Eventually I might get there. I've been there before. I won't say that I couldn't get there again. But I'm not there now. So, you know, I'm just like, eh, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. Money, anyone? I'll move out eventually. Hopefully the YouTube thing works so that I can sustain myself on this, because I really love doing it. It keeps me safe inside, and all, you know, there's just, I can list the pros to making a living on YouTube for hours and hours. I gotta actually make the next channel and start putting stuff on it to actually make it happen. But that's coming very, very soon, as I've explained many times. Very, very, very soon. It's around the corner now. But I gotta start doing that before I can make a living on it, you know? I'm not really making any progress towards it right now. Anyway. That's going to do it for today. Thank you for watching. Remember to like the video. If you like it, subscribe to see more in the future. Comment if you have anything to say, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.